Hey there! Welcome to Life Noggin. Wouldn't it be cool if there was something that can survive space without a special suit? Well, it turns out there is something that awesome, and it's called a tardigrade. They may sound like something you get when you're late for school, but these little guys are basically superheroes. Let's find out why. Tardigrades, or more adorably known as water bears and moss piglets, are a phylum of small invertebrates that are bilaterally symmetrical and have four pairs of legs. They like to munch on things like plant cell fluid and bacteria and try their best to avoid their predators, which can include other tardigrades. That's right. Some tardigrades are cannibals. Talk about trust issues. But just why are these little guys so scientifically awesome? Well, it turns out that our moss piglet friends are super resilient and can survive some pretty extreme conditions. They can handle super cold environments, like ones colder than negative 200 Celsius, and also ones as hot around 150 Celsius. They can also survive extreme radiation, oxygen depletion, and also severe pressures. Some scientists even think that they will outlive humanity. Tardigrades are also thought of as one of the few life forms that can survive the harsh conditions of space, since they have lived at low Earth orbit. In 2007, samples of tardigrades were exposed to a space vacuum and two different ultraviolet radiation spectral ranges. All of the tardigrade samples were exposed to both ionizing solar and galactic cosmic radiation, and both sound really cool. The solar radiation negatively affected their chance of survival, but amazingly, some of these little fellas were still able to survive. So how the heck do they do it? Well, it's all thanks to a process called cryptobiosis. Through this, tardigrades practically stop all metabolic processes and can survive for years in this state. They can dry up into a lifeless ball in what scientists call a tune. They stay in this state until they can come into contact with water again. It's basically the extreme version of playing possum. I don't know about you, but I would love to meet one of these superheroes. Oh, well, that was easy. Thanks, animator. But I would love for my human friends in the real world to meet one too. Well, actually, it turns out you might be able to if you have a good enough microscope. According to some sources, including the awesomely named International Society of Tardigrade Hunters, if you want to see a tardigrade for yourself, go out and find some lichen or moss and place it in a shallow dish. Let it soak in distilled water overnight, and in the morning, squeeze the moss over a transparent dish, like a petri dish, to collect the water. With any luck, you might be able to examine the water under a microscope and get to meet one of these awesome water bears. I'm going to name mine Heimlich. So what do you think about these little guys? Would you keep one as a pet? What would you name your tardigrade? Let me know in the comments section below. And if you're craving even more information on tiny little creatures, then you should definitely check out the video we did on when multicellular life began. It's clear it didn't happen all at once. The main theory is that multicellular organisms started out as cells grouped together in colonies. As always, my name is Blocko. This has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.